Hello, in this video I am going to explain the working of LED chaser circuit built using 555 timer and 4017 decade counter IC. Before going to the working of this circuit, let's see the simulation first. For every positive pulse that is created in this 555 timer IC, this LED gets light on, and at the same time each of the output pin gets activated one at a time in the order of Q0 to Q9 here. We can divide this whole circuit into two blocks, namely 555 timer block and 4017 counter block. Let's see the 555 timer IC first. This IC gets its name 555 from the fact that there are 3 5 kilo ohm resistors found in the comparator circuit inside this IC. Here, what I have shown is belongs to 8-pin dual inline package. I have also used the same package in this project. This IC555 is configured as a stable mode. This is the standard connection to make this IC work in this mode. Control voltage pin is not used in this mode. Hence, 0.01 microfarad capacitor is connected between the control voltage pin and ground. Reset is in active low mode, hence it is connected to the VCC first. If any accidental reset happens, it protects this IC. This capacitor gets discharged through R2. Let's see the decade counter IC next. Here, 16 and 8 are the V plus and ground pin. These are the output pins where the LEDs are connected to. Here also the enable pin is in active low mode. The output frequency of this 555 timer output is adjusted with the help of this formula. R1 and RV1 gets changed with the help of potentiometer we attached in this circuit. This circuit finds application in advertising displays like this one, and small discos light probes are used. This circuit is most commonly used as decorative lights like we see here. Let's end this video with a Tinkercad simulation. Now the LEDs are chased at a high speed. Please note that as I adjust the value of the potentiometer, the speed of the LED gets reduced. We can easily understand this with the help of the formula I mentioned before. In place of IC555 and 4017 decade counter IC, we can use Arduino board. But that is not at all needed for this application. I hope I have mentioned the points needed to understand the working of this circuit. Thanks for your patience listening. Thank you.